Hey, yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays! Today on Newkirk Precinct Tournament Edition, Void Edition, with a TVP, as we have spawning on the bottom left hand side, the red Protoss, it's Kikie, I think. And in the bottom right hand side, for Pro Kings, the blue Terran me, Alex Usher, woo! So I think we had a TVP last time, and we will have a TVP this time as well. So that's cool. Okay, gate, gas, nexus, maybe? We will see. So far, yeah, there we go. Okay. And for me, Rex, gas with some SCV scout, as it looks like. Lol. Yep, that's what's happening right here. And the probe moving out as well. Sure, why not? So still, this game is quite fun to me to play sometimes. On the other hand, it can be very frustrating. But now, for the time being, I feel okay playing this game. I am playing old build orders, which are somewhat still okay to play, so they work quite decent, and so much it's there's not too much going on with patches and so on, so I'm fine. Looks like I can get my command center done soon as well. There we go. The fun part is it's also possible and still quite strong to play command center first into three racks, and those you will get the command center before the opponent gets its nexus on the way. So if you would choose a build order like that and you get the transitions, that's the most important part, scouting and transition, because you don't have the Reaper. Scouting is a little bit different and more difficult, I would say, depending on the map and your opponent, of course. But you get enough marines to basically deal with anything he can throw at you, like Oracle. You just need to scout and be prepared. And then your transition needs to be on point with the factory, the starport, double upgrades, or even just one eBay stim. Can be very difficult to have a solid, some solid plan and transition with that. So that's the case why I don't play it, because I never practiced it. And I basically have no clue about the timings on when to go with the transition. But for now it looks like the Protoss is going for a Robo and Twilight Council, some sort of adder play. The Reaper might be able to scout this. Unseen, unnoticed. Doesn't see the Twilight, but will it will see the Twilight but not the Robo, so that's good. Gets one probe, okay, and there we go. Oh, that was a misclick. Yeah, still don't know about the Robo, but that's fine, I guess. And behind that, yeah, 60 marine double medevac drop, which I think is not the most ideal way to play this out. I think you can play. It's funny, some guys play Banshee, Cloak Banshee, Raven into Cloak Banshee against Protoss, can work. Others go for fast tanks. Then there are some guys who go for 1-1-1 with a fast Widowmine drop, I assume it's gas first then. And some go for a quick third command center. So in TVP, basically there are a lot of different openings you can play as Terran. But of course, on the other hand, you need to know exactly the timings and what to scout for. Oh, adepts. Okay. They shouldn't have done the shade in, so it was a good decision to not do it. To cancel the shade. They're back home. Observer on its way. So normally the observer can hit, depending on. In this case, it was Twilight before Robo. But if it's Robo first, the observer might show up at 4 minutes and 30 seconds in your natural or main, depending on the map and the pathway. So here it's totally fine, and Medivac should boost, there we go, on point, awesome. So with this drop and attack, although it's just 14 marines instead of 16, I still should be able to deal lots of damage. There are only 6 adepts, and with good focus fire and micro, those marines with Medivacs can win such a fight. The sentry could complicate those things with the guardian shield. But yeah, this Nexus is so vulnerable. It needs to get cancelled, I guess. Shade, 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 shade! There we go. But Nexus so low already, second stim coming in, shade's not on point, cancelled, and that was good damage. The Nexus was more than halfway through. Scan for the observer? Nice! And yeah, I can go back in and attack if he would choose to go for a Nexus again. But for now, it's looking like he's just adding more gateways and going up for a big attack to maybe end the game, or at least deal enough pressure or damage in order to, yeah, get the transition out of that behind. So that's always nice. It's a bit late, but still it can work. Glaives should be done. They are. Blink comes out behind that as well. And he's going up to 1, 2, 7 gates. So that's totally fine. War Prism, big weapon possibly. Interesting path to move it like that. I wonder why would you do this? This doesn't seem right to me. Uh-oh, turrets are coming up. Look at that! It looks like I double scan. There we go. That scan was so stupid. But sometimes you never know. Sometimes you never know. Maybe I wanted to check if this third was already up and running, and this is his fourth base, which could be the case. But yeah, the second scan was questionable. And look at the turrets. I like it. Maybe one turret here would be nice. But depending on how he flies in, those turrets are in a phenomenal spot. Hallucinated Phoenix gets picked off. He saw it. He knows there isn't much back at home. In fact, there's nothing back at home. But the barracks did finish up. He's flying across the missile turret. And War Prism dies. 3 adepts making his way in here. I'm a little bit idle. This sentry is so important. And... oh. Okay, that's... huh. I don't know about that, to be honest. Looks like this gets cleaned up very close. But it is indeed enough. But a huge hiccup in my economy. So that was quite good, even though he lost everything. He killed quite some worker. It was worth it, I would say. Definitely. And now I'm back home again. I'm currently only on Marines and Medivacs. So there are no Marauder, nothing else left. Just pure Marines, which is not good against this kind of army, I can tell you. You wanna have some Marauder, there we go, Liberator, that's something which can help. Or maybe tanks or Widowmines, anything, but not just nothing. Okay, there we go, missile turret, sensor turret on the way, double medivac drop, and even more medivacs. Uh-oh, but now I see it's his army, I should not drop. Yeah, good scan. The bunker is so key. Look at how well the bunker can do here. There's a flanking maneuver. Might get this Archon. Not look. Oh, so many Marines in this medivac. That's a huge mistake here. But so far, I delayed his attack. It's 1-1 against 0-1, so it should be ahead. But if I'm throwing units away like that, that's not good. Second scan here on top of his army. There we go, stim again. No guardian shield so far. He could pop it. There we go. I'm not attacking the sentry, which is a huge problem for me. You always should go for the sentry if you can. Especially if you play bio. It blocks 2 damage from each missile, I guess. Oh, that's so close. Can I hold on? Range damage. So not even missiles, but also marines and such. SCVs get pulled. But it looks like I barely can hold here. He's not producing anything. Look at the, not the supply, but his income and the minerals, the This bank. There we go. I should retreat now. It's unlikely to get this prison. But maybe I will get it. Who knows? Oh, it's looking good for me now. Pew pew! There we go. Okay. Yeah, what I wanted to say, Guardian Shield blocks two damage from each attack. So the Marines will, instead of doing 7 damage, only 2. I mean 5. But also there is armor on this army now, so they will do like 2 damage, 3 damage. And same is for applies for the Marauder. Like they have 2 attacks, so if you need to focus the sentry ASAP. That's the most important unit you can attack here. I don't know why he did do that. I mean, he didn't take any real damage, so that was fine. Oh. He's going for 2-2 attack now. 2-2 upgrades and Storm. This is good. I'm on 2-1 with 2-3 on the way. And getting some tanks, another starport, another command center. I would say it's looking okay. However, this is a very low tech game in terms of supply. I mean, macro wise, it's quite low. That's what I mean. Like, we are not maxed, although we are long way in the game where we could be maxed out. But that's not the case. Missile turret's now in a good position. Will be hard for him to use this prison for harassment, but for reinforcement, that could work. We do have one tank. Oh, that's some good. Oh, look at that drop. That's so good. And he's robbing right on top of the Marines. That's a huge mistake. All those units just died, so he was wasting all his bank. This entire bank there. He comes in. He has Storm. There's a Liberator. 2 Liberator. The Storms are hitting hard. Really good. More Storms. Bunker gets not repaired currently. This tank in prime position. Liberator. Ah, the bunker! So close! This tank dishing out more and more damage. It looks like I can hold this. The Archon will get taken out. In the meantime, I killed the Nexus. And now I can go for the flanking maneuver here. Ah, the sandwich is real! Will I get the Archon? Yes, I will! And this army is so dead. Ah, the stutter step mistakes! Oh, overstimmed like crazy! But I have enough medivacs. Not enough energy, but enough medivacs, so that's good. Enough. Numb. There's the warp prism. There's the adapt. Yeah, I should kill this adapt before I land one. Oh no! Kill the adapt! No! This adapt will have hell of a time over here. It looks like I might just go for this base, but yeah, there we go. I don't know if that's looking too good for the Protoss player so far. Overall, I would say, even though I'm doing quite some mistakes, it looks like I have a solid game in this game. I had. So, I love this tank. This tank and this Liberator are in a prime position. If you have a position like this with a bunker, a turret, 2 Liberators set up here, I mean located here, having their liberation zones here and here, in order to defend the tank, and maybe some bio to buffer. This is such a huge, difficult position to break. Ah, the prism! And it dies. And there's not much damage to find. Nope. So he killed so many SCVs, but gas-wise, I am ahead a lot in terms of trading. Army wise, army against army, tech against tech, versus whatever. Moai Templar, he needs some other source of. There we go, robotics bay, finally. The problem with Storm is, and that's why you don't see it that often in professional games, is it is so easy to dodge. Really, Storm is super easy to dodge. Maybe you can see it right now. I'm not a professional. But those storms, that was a really good storm. But overall, if you don't have lots of High Templars and storms, you can dodge storms quite good. Look at that. Some Marines died, some more died, but it's nothing compared to a disruption over killing like 14 units at once. Storm is too slow. in my opinion. It's still powerful, it's a good addition to your army as Blood Dust. But I see, now I see why my Protoss player tend to go for Colossus and Disruptor instead of Storm. Losing one. Look at that, no damage at all. Almost. That was some good Storm. But normally you can dodge Storm quite well. I think this is gonna be game. There's nothing here to defend, so with the Blink Stalker, you should be able to kill this. Not enough upgrades here. But overall it's looking bad for Kikia. Another safety scan just in case of DTs. That's game. GG. So that's it with that episode. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care, bye bye.